Ibogaine is a drug that has been mentioned by many former heroin addicts to be the reason why they quit heroin. It is a drug that has been reported to significantly reduce the opioid withdrawal symptoms that occur when a heroin user tries to quit. However, it is illegal in the US and considered a Schedule 1 drug, and so in this video we will talk about how true the claims are that Ibogaine can help treat heroin addiction, and if so, then why it is illegal in the US. So ibogaine is a naturally occurring psychoactive alkaloid that is found in the Iboga plant, which is a rainforest shrub native to Western Africa. It is used in low doses to combat hunger and thirst, and in high doses for ritual purposes by the Bwiti tribe in the Congo Basin of Africa for African spiritual traditions. They extract the ibogaine by chewing on the plant. High concentrations can be found in the root bark, with low concentrations in the rest of the plant. It was popularized in the US by a man called Howard Lotsoff in 1962. Now, Howard was a heroin addict who had heard of the psychoactive properties of ibogaine, so him and five of his addict friends decided they would try it out for recreational purposes. Upon using, they noticed a reduction in their heroin cravings and withdrawal symptoms, and so he went on to spread the word. Now, there isn't a huge amount of research on the effectiveness of ibogaine for treating opioid withdrawal or a full understanding of how the drug works in the body, mainly because it is banned in the US as the World Health Assembly classified ibogaine as a substance likely to cause dependency or endanger human health. And so a lot of the ibogaine treatment clinics and research are done outside the US. However, let's have a look at the research that has been done on it. There was one clinical trial that lasted between 1962 to 1993 where 33 heroin addicts were administered a range of low doses of ibogaine. 25 out of the 33 participants showed a reduction in opioid withdrawal symptoms 24 to 72 hours after treatment, but one patient died, which questioned the safety of the drug, which we will talk about in a bit. Another study that was published in 2006 reported that ibogaine significantly decreased the cravings for cocaine and heroin, and also observed that their patients suffered less depressive symptoms even 30 days after the ibogaine treatment. A study in Brazil stated that ibogaine caused a long-term reduction of withdrawal symptoms in 20% of their participants, with a study in New Zealand stating they got the same results for 50% of their patients. Researchers in Brazil who combined ibogaine with psychotherapy found a long-term reduction in withdrawal symptoms in 69% of their patients. And lastly, researchers at the Johns Hopkins School of Medicine interviewed 88 subjects and found that 80% of their subjects reported that ibogaine either drastically reduced or completely got rid of all their withdrawal symptoms, with 30% saying they avoided opioid use for years following their ibogaine treatment. Once ingested, ibogaine is converted to noribogaine in the body, and it goes on to bind to several neurotransmitters in the brain, including the same receptors that heroin binds to. It also increases the availability of a neurotransmitter in the brain called serotonin, which regulates anxiety, happiness, and mood, and these effects may be the reason for the reported reduction in drug withdrawal symptoms. So what happens when you take the drug? Well, firstly, there are the effects on the body. The biggest immediate and common effect of taking ibogaine is a partial or full loss of control of body movement. Other effects can include nausea, dry mouth, dizziness, and vomiting, and these effects are the reason why it's uncommon to see ibogaine being taken for recreational purposes. Then there are the psychological effects of ibogaine. As I mentioned, it is a psychoactive drug, and the effects it can have on its users are quite unique. The psychological effects can be split into three phases. The first phase is the acute phase, or the awakened dream state, which can last between 4 to 8 hours. This phase is described as a waking dream state, which involves visual experiences of past memories where the user is in a visual landscape. The second phase is called the reflective phase, which can last from 8 to 20 hours, where the user experiences less visual dreams but spends their time reflecting what they have experienced or learned from the first phase, thus the name reflective phase. These two phases are the reason why the drug is used for spiritual development. The last phase, which is called the residual stimulation phase, lasts 24 to 72 hours and is basically where the psychoactive effects of the drug start to wear off and the user gets back to reality. So if ibogaine has shown quite positive results in reducing opioid withdrawal symptoms and keeping people away from highly addictive drugs, why is it banned? Well, firstly, due to its psychoactive effects. Secondly, because ibogaine interacts with an enzyme in the body called cytochrome P450-2D6, which is an enzyme that interacts with many other drugs. As a result, ibogaine can have toxic interactions with other commonly used medications. Thirdly, ibogaine can lead to death in people with pre-existing heart conditions, as it can be quite taxing on the heart. And lastly, medical records between 1990 to 2008 have shown that 19 people have died from 1 to 3 hours after taking Ibogaine. However, that being said, none of those deaths were linked to the toxic effects of the drug, but more likely due to interactions with other medications the user had been using, or pre-existing medical conditions such as heart problems. Drug interactions and severe effects on people with certain medical problems are common with many other legal drugs, which is why we have doctors and pharmacists who check a patient's medical history before prescribing a drug. In the case of Ibogaine, because it is an illegal drug in the US, heroin addicts are going to clinics in other countries where the people prescribing Ibogaine are not screening the patients first and the clinics are not regulated. As a result, it is important to do more research on Ibogaine to assess its safety and effectiveness before banning it. If it is found to be the wonder drug that many people claim it to be, with legalization and regulation, Ibogaine may help millions of people worldwide beat their heroin addiction. If you have found this video interesting, please subscribe to the channel and check out the other videos.